गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। दिस इज रिवीजन, सो योर पोर्शंस आर ऑलरेडी ओवर, जस्ट यू प्रिपेयर योर सब्जेक्ट, मीन्स कंप्यूटर सब्जेक्ट यू प्रिपेयर फॉर द फाइनल एग्जामिनेशन एंड बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन। दिस इज रिवीजन, रिवीजन फ्रॉम द बिगनिंग। सो फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू कंप्यूटर लैंग्वेज। दिस इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू computer language, okay, and all of you know here that like computer language there are some more languages which we are using in our daily life. To communicate with each other we need a language, we require a language to express our ideas and views with someone, and to understand the views and ideas of someone we need a language. Some are talking in Hindi, some are English, some Malayalam, some Gujarati. So there are different types of the language, different types of the sources with the help of which we can communicate with each other. Okay. By the way, what is your language you are talking? Okay. Which language? English or Hindi? Okay. Similarly, we require a special language that a computer can understand. Is known as programming language or computer language. Two types of computer languages are. So here are two types computer languages: low level language and high level language. Okay. Low level language is directly understandable by the computer, even for us also. We can also understand the low level language. So here I would like to tell you that the language which we can understand easily without the help of any translator, that is low level language for us also. Okay, suppose we can directly understand Hindi, so Hindi is very low level for us. Suppose we cannot understand English, so English is very tough language or high level language for us. So dear students, this is the category how we are making a low level language and how we understand this is high level language. So here we are talking about the computer languages. So computer languages means low level language and high level language. High level language like Fortran, C, Pascal, these are the high level languages, and the low level language are categorized in assembly language and machine language. What is low level language? Low level language is the language which is directly understandable by the computer. This is known as the machine code or machine language, and that is binary code 0 and 1. The program written in the form of the 0 and 1 can be directly understandable by the computer, but we cannot understand easily. This is very tough for us which we are getting the machine code 0 and 1. All of you know that writing in the machine code is very difficult to understand by everyone. The programmers only can understand it and it will take time also. So if any program we write in the low level language, it is very difficult for us. So high level language came in the third generation, and using this language we can easily write the program codes using high level language. Okay, for example C, Fortran, COBOL, this Java, these are the high level languages which can be used to create any program, to develop any software easily. Okay, so low level language you got, that is directly understandable by the computer. Then next one is here, the low level language is also divided into two parts. One is machine language, another one is assembly language. There are two ways, there are two parts of the low level language. The next one is high level language. High level language, the high level languages are the most used and also more considered programming language. Okay, these are C, C++, Java. Java you are using as your computer language in your syllabus. So Java is a high level language. So what is high level language? In which a translator is required to translate our program. Okay, we cannot directly create a program in the machine code. So here high level language instructions are written in English, like keywords, variables and constants, etc., which are easily understandable by the programmer, means for us. The person who write a program is known as the programmer, but not directly understood by the computer system. So we are writing class, public wide, we are writing system out, println, we are writing index, and whatever codes we are giving in the program is not directly understandable by the computer, because that is not a low level, that is a high level. So high level we can understand easily, but computer does not understand directly the high level language. So how does computer understand high level language? It is here. It requires a translator that can convert the high level language into machine language. Machine language, you know, that is the low level language 01. Two types of the translators are there, which are translating our program. Translating our program in the low level language means converting our source code into machine code. So there are two translator, compiler and interpreter. Compiler takes a whole program in the memory at once, and it compile whole programs at a time. Interpreter reads the program line by line, and it translate in the machine code. Okay, so these are the difference in both. Interpreter translate the programs line by line, and compiler compiles the program, whole program at once. Right. Types of programming languages are here. One is one programming language is used to develop the system software. It is known as a system programming language. For example, Windows, DOS, these are the operating systems are created by the system programming languages. Okay, and another one is application programming language, means your campus care you are using every day. Campus care is developed in application programming language, Microsoft Word, or any software which are used for our purpose to solve our problem is the application programming language. And the softwares which are used to run the computers to control all the input and output devices and all the functions of the computers are controlled by the system programming languages, that is operating system. Okay, system software is the operating system, and that is Windows, that is Linux, that is Unix. There are different types of the computer different types of the operating systems. Application softwares are here. For example, we can use the banking, railways, schools using campus care nowadays. Introduction to OOPs, object-oriented programming. You know that object-oriented programming language is your Java, is the object-oriented programming language. The whole program or part of the program can be used in other programs. So what happens in the object-oriented programming language? The programs once written, no need to write again and again. By the creation of the object, we can use the same program or same codes in other program. These are categorized, the programming are categorized here, COPs and OOPs, object-oriented programming and procedure-oriented programming. Okay. This is one thing, object. Object, all of you know, the thing about which we can communicate, we can think, that is object. For example, here pen, cat, car, school, etc. These are the object. And blackboard, whiteboard, laptop, camera, okay, this jacket. Whatever you think means whatever you are having in your hand, that is one object about which we can think or we can communicate. That is one object. So here every object has the following characteristics. It is having its identity, states and behavior, that already you know. You read the PDF and you understand properly. Many times you have taught these topics, but this is a revision. So once again, just I am reminding you that you prepare these topics, because in the final examination and as well as the pre-board examination, such type of the topics are asked by 2 marks. Which is these topics will help you to get 2 marks for the final examination and pre-board examination. Okay, so these things you know. Suppose there is a bike, so bike is identity, its color and bike, these are the characteristics of the bike. Starting and changing gear is the behavior of the bike, it may be on or off, so these are the quality of the objects. Principle of object-oriented programming. Principle of object-oriented programming means why a programming language is known as object-oriented programming. What are the features of that? Okay, कि हम किसी भी प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेजेस को ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग क्यों कहेंगे. सो दीज आर द टॉपिक्स हियर, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 फीचर्स आर देयर. इफ एनी